Hey everyone, if you've been motherboard hunting, you might have seen that there's like $100 or £100 motherboards and then like $400 or £400 motherboards. Which should you actually buy? Like, is one much faster than the other? Will the $400 one get you four times the gaming performance of the $100 one? Well, the short answer is no, it absolutely won't. But there are some key differences with motherboards that are worth knowing about, so that you don't accidentally buy the wrong one and have a false economy where you kind of spend too little money and then have to sell it and actually buy a slightly better motherboard. So the first thing to know is power phases. Motherboards sometimes list things like 8 plus 2 plus 1 power phases. And what that actually refers to is the VRM setup on the motherboard, and this is actually responsible for power delivery to the rest of the components, such as the CPU, and that, as this name would suggest, is quite an important thing, because obviously if your CPU isn't properly supplied with power, that clearly is not going to be a good thing. But if you've got a mid-range CPU, for example, this isn't really something to worry about. You know, you could actually buy a budget motherboard with budget VRM setups, and you're probably not going to have any real issues. You're probably going to get the same gaming performance as, you know, if you put in that CPU in a really high-end motherboard. If you were, for example, buying an Epic or Threadripper CPU, then things like that would become a lot more important. Equally, if you go for like, you know, a 9800X3D, one of the best gaming chips on the market right now, and actually put that in a super budget motherboard, you might get slightly less performance than if you put in a mid-range or higher-end motherboard, but it's certainly not going to be completely significant either. But power phases, for example, isn't something that would make me want to run out and change my motherboard if I had a slightly more budget one, so I just wanted to reassure you on that. But there are actually other factors that are more important. The first one is the PCI Express slot on the motherboard, because you've got different generations. You've got PCI Express Gen 5, Gen 4, and Gen 3. They're the most common, of course. Gen 2 does exist, but that's kind of ancient nowadays. And what you notice in is recent motherboards that support the latest AM5 Ryzen CPUs, they actually have PCI Express Gen 5, and then that works with the RTX 50 series of graphics cards because they are PCI Express Gen 5. However, it's not actually the end of the world if you have a B650 motherboard with a Gen 4 slot, because benchmarks have actually shown that there's only like 1 to 3% performance difference between putting an RTX 50 series card in a Gen 4 or a Gen 5 slot. So it's not the end of the world either, but it is something to be aware of. The other thing you should check with motherboards is actually how the M2 drives are set up, and that's because the motherboard might actually have like 3 M2 NVMe slots, but it might be that one of them is Gen 4 and then the other ones are Gen 3. And that's not the end of the world. I mean, you're not going to have a massive performance hit or anything like that, but the Gen 4 drives might be running at over 7,000 megabytes per second of read and write speeds, whereas the Gen 3 slots are running at more like 3 to 3,500 megabytes per second. And that's not going to make a massive difference when you're gaming, but it is worth knowing that if you do lots of file transfers and things like that as part of your work or whatever, then actually having that extra bandwidth from a Gen 4 or a Gen 5 slot will actually make a difference. So that is one area where some motherboards are faster than other ones. But certainly if your main use case is gaming, then you probably could get by with a more budget motherboard, as long as you're not pairing it with like a super high-end CPU or something like that. But even the 9800X3D has been known to run absolutely fine on a more budget B650 motherboard. So that is good to know. But if you've got any further questions at all, please let me know down in the comments. And other than that, if you enjoyed this video, please click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more short videos like this. Thanks for watching.